What do we know about people who become addicted as far as traits? There are some people who say, I can't take an oxycodone or an OxyContin because it makes me ill. I just don't like the feeling it gives me. And yet other people will continue to take them and then find they're addicted.
Yeah, so it's thought that about 50% of the risk is genetic. And it's not a single gene. It's typically a number of different genes, and I'm sure we haven't even identified all of the genes. And then, of course, you have to have exposure to the drug, or you won't get it. Even if you have underlying risk factors, you won't get it if you are not exposed to the drug. And then another piece that's really important is people who have underlying risk factors that have made their stress response system of the brain abnormal. So this would be people who have underlying depression, anxiety, PTSD, mental health disorders, and importantly, a lot of persons who grew up and had adverse childhood experiences have these kind of underlying abnormal stress response. So you can measure this with like cortisol levels and things that they are not, that part of the brain is somewhat dysfunctional. And that seems to be a risk factor for patients to feel more normal when they take these medications. Because a lot of patients, when they take these medications, they feel awful. They, you know, it makes them have all kinds of side effects and that sort of thing. But there's a population with some of these risk factors that when they take the medicine, they feel actually better. And they have the euphoria that that has been spoken about. And so those people are much more likely to want to take it again because they felt so much better taking it.